Hello friends, welcome to Ranju's Food Fusion. I'm Ranju. Today I'm going to make strawberry jam with all the fresh ingredients. I'm not using any artificial preservatives. So let's check out the recipe.
To make strawberry jam, here I have 450 grams of strawberries, 1 teaspoon of lemon juice, 1 cup of sugar, and 1/3 of gala apple.
Now everyone has one question. Why are we using apple in the strawberry jam? Whenever we buy jams from the store, they have an ingredient which is called pectin. They have pectin in it. And what pectin does to the jam, whenever pectin heats up with the sugar, and then it gives a nice consistency to the jam. But we are not using any artificial ingredient today. And so rather than pectin powder, we are using an apple in a jam. But if you have Granny Smith apple or green apple, you can use that one, because those ones has the higher amount of pectin in it. But if you don't have that, you can also use gala apple. This one also has good amount of pectin in it. But do not worry, you will not get any taste of apple in your strawberry jam.
So here I have 18 strawberries. These are washed and dried up with the paper towel. I will chop 12 strawberries out of them. I'll chop them in very small pieces. And rest of the 6 strawberries, I'll put it in a blender jar and make a puree out of it. While making the puree of these strawberries, I will not add any water. Just blend it in the blender jar. You will get a nice puree out of it. And here you can see I have a nice puree out of those strawberries. Now we'll peel the apple. And we'll grate the apple. We need only 1/3 apple. So we'll just grate 1/3 apple and we'll leave rest of the apple. Now transfer the chopped strawberries in a kadahi or a pan. Add the grated apple too. Now mash it with the potato masher. So we can crush some of the strawberries too and get some juice out of it also. And we'll get some pieces of strawberries also. Now add strawberry puree. And we will add our 1 cup of sugar too. Now firstly cook this all mixture on high heat for 10 minutes. Just mix in between while it's cooking. To test the jam, we need a cold plate. For that, I will put this plate in the freezer and I will take it out when I will be ready to check the jam. And you can see how it's nicely boiling on high heat. Let it boil, but mix in between while it's boiling. Now after 10 minutes, you can see how color is also changed slowly. Now we will add 1 teaspoon of lemon juice to it and cook it for another 4 to 5 minutes. Stir in between. Now after 5 minutes, it looks like the jam is coming to a right consistency. We will check the jam. To check the jam, I'll take out cold plate from the freezer and I'll put some amount of jam on it and I will swipe a finger out of it. And you can see the jam is staying on its place. It's not coming back to fill the gap. It means our jam is ready. If the jam is coming back in between the gap, it means you can cook it for 2-3 minutes more. But we can see here, it's not coming back. It means our jam is right. So I'll switch off the heat. And you can see it doesn't seem too much thick, because when it's get cold, it will get a little bit more thicker than this, what we see now. So now our jam is ready. I will pour it in a container. Here I'm using a glass container. I like to use glass container for jams. But make sure your container is very clean and dry. There shouldn't be any speck of water inside it. So now I can pour the jam in the container. This jam is still hot, so I will just leave it on the counter and let it come to the room temperature. Once it's come to the room temperature, I will close the lid and keep it in the refrigerator for 3 to 4 days. And after that, I will show you how the consistency is there. Actually, this jam was kept in the refrigerator for past 5 days. And now I'm opening it and we'll see how the consistency is. The consistency is really nice and spreadable. And it's really yummy too. See how easily I can spread it? Now we will put another slice of bread on top of this and I will cut a jam bread sandwich. And here is our bread jam ready with homemade jam. This jam tastes awesome. My daughter only eats this jam. She doesn't like any other jam. Thanks for watching. Please like and share the video. And don't forget to subscribe, Ranju's Food Fusion.
So with this way, you can make strawberry jam at home with all fresh ingredients. Please try the recipe and enjoy. And don't forget to subscribe, Ranju's Food Fusion, for more recipes.